There's a lead rope being hoisted out the back of the gates. The starter hit the button, let them go. Just handy from the inside, the first of them to leave and out. Well, also Scorpion Storm's heels are plenty. Paris Girl jumped on terms but couldn't get across and immediately drifting back into the field. Double Spice boots up now to join it. Also the Cat Ratcher driving through against the rail. Blue Horse is back there and so is the Thunderous, but it's Just Handy who led them clearly. As they'd settled down, they leave the back. They're on the far turn, 900 to go. Just Handy with the ears pricked, a length and a half on heels are plenty. Scorpion Storm's beautifully placed by Chris Parnham. Brother Brad has Double Spice up there running fourth. Around them Paris Girl, she's forced to cover ground. Then came the Cat Ratcher, back there the Thunderess, and last of all the grey mare Blue Horse at the 550. They come up towards the turn and it's Just Handy making play. Clear a length and a half, heels are plenty. Scorpion Storm's bides its time now, waits on the cutaway. Double Spice, though extricated to the outside, starting its run, followed by Paris Girl, the Cat Ratcher at the 300. Just Handy's a length and a half on heels of plenty. Brad Parnham goes to work now on Double Spice. Scorpion Storms battles away towards the inside. 150 left to go, still Just Handy the leader, a length clear. Scorpion Storms picking it up on the inside late. Scorpion Storms, Just Handy, they'll hit it locked together. I thought that it might have been Just Handy and no Scorpion Storms in a very tight go from Double Spice, third home, then the Cat Ratcher. Blue Horse was next in, followed further back by heels of plenty, Paris Girl, and the Thunderess is the last of them to arrive. Looked as though it might have been Just Handy as we stand by for the placings. Scorpion Storm's coming at it in the shadows of the post. Just Handy, Boy Hill, stretching the neck and pinning those ears back, finds the line and does it from start to finish. That's two in a row and three from its past five. The Galah mare, trained by Bobby McPherson. Number six, Just Handy, scrambles home from Scorpion Storms, Chris Parnham, and back there third will be Double Spice. So just disregard those numbers that are on the infield board for the moment. 6-3, now one. They've been corrected, 6-3 and 1, here after the running of the fifth of the day. Fourth placing coming to hand goes the way of nine in the Cat Ratcher, and it was ahead one length, the official margins. 119.37 here, posted for the 1300, 34.05, the back end split. Just Handy proving to be a pretty handy mare indeed by Galah from Playhouse Theatre for Bob McPherson, Brian Zirkle, B. Ramsey, C. Gilmore, and Mrs. B. Lammy. That's a third victory in 14, trained by veteran horseman Bob McPherson and handled by Boy Hill, defeating Scorpion Storms by Ukbar from Northerly Gale in the Josh Crispin Yard. Chris Parnham in the saddle, and Double Spice by Gingerbread Man out of Single Spice. Brad Parnham for trainer Stephen Miller weighing in third place, with the Cat Ratcher fourth home, making it 6-3-1-9 in the Salinger Handicap. Going to race six, the Byron Bay Premium Lager Handicap, over 1,000. The next and eight permission is the scratching. As we head down now to the enclosure, and she's certainly proving to be a nice little money spinner for Bob McPherson and his partners, Just Handy, after winning the fifth event of the day. Britt?
A really nice win, and the partners all here in the mounting yard. I'm very happy with you, Bob. Congratulations on the win. Hey, back-to-back victories. You must be very pleased with her effort.
Yeah, very excited. She's out of a mare that had a lot of guts, and this mare is exactly the same, so we're all happy. So it's the first time for a long time I've had a horse put two together, so I'm quite excited. Yeah.
And she had to show that guts today. You saw the horse to her inside really putting in a fight. Knowing the mare, did you think that she was going to be able to gain the upper hand in a bit of a dogfight to the finish?
The mother was like that, and I've got to congratulate the jockey because he said, I want to lead on her. There's no speed in the race, and we'll dictate terms, and it's one of these things that's worked out. Good plan come together, you know.
So obviously, you know the family so well. This is a horse you bred?
Yeah, we bred the mare. Yeah, we bred it, and we've had, you know, it's all come to good. The owners are the original owner of Playhouse Theatre, so we're all stuck together. Jim, she did fight. She fought well. Jim Gilmore, one of the owners, he's not too well medically. So I'm pleased for everyone in the horse.
It's amazing how horses can be a great tonic when someone's not well, isn't it?
Yeah, I've been off the scene for about 3 months, and I've got to congratulate Milton Campbell and the staff at home, everyone that supported me. It's the first day at the races for a long time, so it was nice.
I was thinking we haven't seen you in quite some time. How important is it having good teams at home in your absence?
You can't operate without it. You know, you've got a Chelsea at home that rides in all the work. There's a lot of people behind the scenes. You've got to, they do jobs for you. So it was quite pleasing. You know?
Well, first day back at the races. You enjoy this, you deserve it. Well done.
Thank you.
There's Bob McPherson. Brilliant to see him at the races and to celebrate just Handy putting together back-to-back wins. Boy Hill is with Michael.
Yes, he was just sweating up the owners then. Should be a nice little sling coming his way. Ryan, took 10 starts to break her maiden status, and she's since won 3 of 5. What do you think has been... What's turned the corner?
I didn't have much to do with her early days, and then I rode her one day and I said to Bobby, let's put the blinkers on. And I actually got Bob in trouble because the start before they'd ridden her back, and I told him, I'll come in the mounting yard, so we've got to ride her forward. And Bobby got a bit of a telling off, but it's paid off because her runs have all been super consistent ever since.
And didn't look to be much speed in today's race, especially after Shake It was scratched. So you must have been pleased to dictate on your own terms.
Yeah, I was. I would have been happy to be in the box seat just for something to follow. She's in front a long way, but got it real cheap, and she gave a good kick and done well to fight off that horse at the end.
Think she can go on with it?
I think she can. Bobby will place her well. There's a race next week and probably have to go to the claim, but the way she's bouncing around, it probably wouldn't hurt to run her again next week, and it's good to see Bob back on track.
Yeah, certainly. Well done.
Thank you.
After the victory on Just Handy for Bob McPherson and all the owners out here as well today to see their mare win the Salinger Handicap.
It's like to be a zero, zero. Let me show you what it's like to always feel, feel like I'm empty and there's nothing really real, real. I'm looking for a way out. Hello, hello. Let me tell you what it's like to be a zero, zero. Let me show you what it's like to never feel, feel like I'm good enough for anything that's real, real. I'm looking for a way out. I find out how to tell you how I wanna run away. I understand it always makes you feel a certain way. I find a balance in the middle of the chaos. Send me up, send me down, send me never, demigod. I remember walking in the heat of the summer, wide-eyed one with a mind full of wonder. 27 years and I've nothing to show. Falling from the dust.